Honorable Minister Harshavardhan ji, who is a very accomplished doctor also, that I have never opposed the introduction of the bill, as has already been pointed out by my esteemed colleague Bhartari Mahatab ji. What I have opposed is the way government has been indulging in resorting the route of ordinance, which is unhealthy for the democracy. Sir, the ordinance under Article 1 to 3 of the Constitution provides for the issue of ordinance by the President subject to the condition that the Parliament approves within 6 weeks of its next meeting. We know it. But when the ordinance was promulgated, it is a case of promulgation and re-promulgation of the ordinances. So there is a time and space dimension in every occasion, in every discussion. In the light of the fact that when elections were approved and a change in the composition of Parliament could be possible, then the executive should not issue this kind of ordinance, which is contrary to the moral right. That is the reason that the Constitution provides for a vote on account mode by the outgoing government. That is only for 4 months. The vote on account was an established instrument of this Parliament before the election. That is why I am strongly objecting the time for the invocation of this kind of ordinances. Sir, so it may be safely called that this is an ordinance stand registration upon which we are going to have our discussion. Honorable Health Minister has been rolling out chapter after chapter, para after para, in order to substantiate his argument, but I think everything has been ended in smoke because he has been failed utterly to convince anybody whosoever in this house to substantiate the argument for the ordinance. Yes, aapne keh rahe the ki परसेप्शन मेडिकल काउंसिल के बारे में ऐसा है. हम भी जानते हैं एमसीआई के बारे में परसेप्शन क्या है. ये स्कैम टेंटेड एक अथॉरिटी बन गए हैं, ये हम भी जानते हैं. दी 1956 एक्ट प्रोवाइड फॉर सप्रेशन ऑफ द एमसीआई एंड इट रिकॉन्स्टिट्यूशन विद इन ए पीरियड ऑफ 3 ईयर्स फ्रॉम द डेट ऑफ इट्स सुपरसीशन. In the interim period, the Act requires the central government to constitute a board of governors to exercise the powers of the MCI. Yes. The bill amends the Act to reduce the time period for supervision of the MCI from 3 years to 2 years. This is one issue. Second, the Act provides for the board of governors to consist of up to 7 members, including persons of eminence in medical education appointed by the central government. The bill amends the provision to increase the strength of the board from 7 members to 12 members. Further, it allows for persons with proven administrative capacity and experience to be selected in the board. The bill provides for the board of governors to be assisted by a secretary general appointed by the central government. Yes, your objective is to ensure accountability, quality, everything, which is imperative needs for a structure like MCI. Sir, in your statement, you have pointed out that Standing Committee on Health and Family Welfare has proposed for National Medical Council Bill. May I ask you, why you are adopting this kind of piecemeal approach? Why? Why you are not adopting the way for permanent solution, that is to bring a holistic and comprehensive legislation? Because आपने अगर कह रहे हैं कि perception हमारे MCI की खराब हो रहे हैं, तो जब perception खराब हो रहे हैं तो quality कैसे maintain होगा, accountability कैसे maintain होगा, transparency कैसे maintain होगा? तो आपको किसने रोका है कि एक comprehensive legislation लाने के लिए? आप क्यों बार बार ordinance, re-ordinance करते करते इस तरीके की आप रास्ता अपना रहे हैं? हम भी तो चाहते हैं एक कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव लेजिस्लेशन लाया जाए. सो इट इज आई सब्सक्राइब टू द व्यू एक्सप्रेस बाय ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर दैट दिस इज नथिंग बट अ वेरी प्रोसीज्यूरल बिल एंड ऑल्सो इट डज नॉट एड्रेस द इश्यू इन हैंड. इट इज अ मेयर स्टॉप गैप अरेंजमेंट एंड कंसिडरिंग द MCI रिपीटेड फ्लाउटिंग ऑफ डायरेक्टिव वन कैन सेफली आर्ग्यू दैट सच ए पैरेलल स्ट्रक्चर विल नॉट बी इफेक्टिव इन हैंडलिंग द इश्यू इन हैंड. You are simply replacing MCI into Board of Governors. Do you think that the constitution of Board of Governors will be an efficacious structure to deal with this deteriorating situation across the country? The government's commitment to resolving the issue could be put to test through the National Medical Council Bill. Yes, in this light, the broad issue with the NMC ranging from over centralization that has been pointed out by you, under representation of states, and field specific issues like entry of AYUSH doctors, flouting of medical ethics, silence over curriculum indifference towards capitation fee, etc., all are all indicative of the government's incompetence and unwillingness in revamping the field for better. On the one hand, you are talking about revamping the sector, but in reality you are not at all serious and rather indifferent. That is why the sector is not being revamped. However, there is an enormous potentialities in this health sector. Everybody knows it. The sector has been growing by leaps and bounds. We need a driving force of quality education in order to revamp this institution. Aging of population, rising incomes of middle class, occurrence of newer diseases, development of primary care facilities are expected to save the industry in future, provided you are serious enough. You are referring the fake faculty patients on higher rented medical equipment are some of the dubious means adopted by several medical colleges across the country aimed at duping inspector who visit college to scrutinize facilities before granting or renewing permission for admission before the start of every academic session. Sir, an RTI query I would like to refer here. An RTI query has revealed that only 920 government medical college seats were added in the last 5 years against an approval of 10,000 seats. To place this statistic in perspective, India today has just one government allopathic doctor for over 11,000 people. When private practitioners are taken into account, according to the findings of National Health Profile 2018, this is against the World Health Organization norms of one doctor is to 1,000 population. When private practitioners are taken into account, the ratio looks more respectable at one doctor for about 1,600 people. But private care is both expensive and of uncertain quality, for which the state of medical education is substantially to blame. Hence, a robust, regulated private health space needs to coexist with a growing presence of government hospital and colleges. Honorable Minister, you have failed to refer the other suggestions of the standing committee, 92, I mean standing committee report, that this government has been stingy enough to expend on this sector, because the expenditure of health vis-a-vis our GDP is as abysmal as 1.8%. However, the standing committee repeatedly has been proposing for 2.5% of GDP to be spent for the health sector. According to Medical Council of India, which regulates both medical practice and education, there are about 500 private and government medical colleges offering nearly 62,000 seats, when our country needs 1 million doctors per year, of which the latter accounts for about half the number, I mean government medical colleges. The paucity of government doctors is therefore also due to the large number of graduates opting for private practice. Medical education was thrown open to the private sector about 3 decades ago to address the sheer paucity of doctors. Today, a cocktail of unethical practices, sheer incompetence and lack of inclusiveness needs to be dealt with. It is an open secret that seats in medical colleges can be bought for a price that can go up to few crore. Such colleges produce dubious doctors who are focused on recovering their expenses. At the other end, even reputed institutions such as the new
3 minutes, so
how much
conclude? Time allocated was 10 minutes. You've already 30.
10 minutes?
It's already 15 minutes, so.
Doctor to. Acha. At the other even reputed institutions such as new aims, facilities in small towns lack faculty and infrastructure. Doctors should rather work to teach for larger sums in private hospitals. To level the scales, working condition in government hospital needs
Chowdhury,
to improve.
You have five right minutes. To reply.
5 minutes, 5 minutes. Madam, 5 minutes.
So you have a right
yes,
to reply,
yes,
otherwise your members...
I know. He is under my care. To level the scales, working condition in government hospital needs to improve. As for medical education, there can be no substitute for the varied hands-on clinical experience that public hospital can provide. Madam, I would like to refer two newspaper reports. One,
please do so.
82% shortfall in specialists puts healthcare on sick bed. Honorable Dr. Harshvardhan ji, the crisis in India's public health infrastructure is laid bare by stark official statistics that reveal that the country faces a shortfall of around 82% in specialists.
Mr. Chowdhury, in your response, whatever else you want to bring up, bring it up in your response.
Why?
You have to speak in any ways. You'll get extra time as your response time also.
Madam, I know why are you restricting myself.
No.
Our time is half an hour. Yes, our time has been allocated for half an hour.
No, 11 minutes.
Then I'm sitting down.
11 minutes was your time. You've already exceeded. That's what I'm saying.
I know that half an hour has been allocated to us.
No, sir. 11 minutes has been allocated. There's a sheet. 11 minutes has been allocated, out of which you've already taken more than 14
minutes. Okay, 2 points I am addressing. The committee would like to draw the attention.
Kindly, whatever else you want to say, say it in your response. You will get right. You have a right to response also.
Doctor, whether we will be able to achieve the sustainable development goals for 2030 in this situation. For people between the age of 30 and 70 in India, according to Lancet reports, the risk of dying from one of the four major NCDs was 20% in women, 27% in men. The committee is dismayed at the increasing burden of non-communicable diseases in the country, as the statistics suggest that the country has made limited national progress in the NCD front. The committee therefore recommends that the ministry should take effective measures to reduce the major risk factor of NCD and promote lifestyle changes. Okay.
Thank you.